the contract.
The broadcast is listed.
Thank you. How about it for the Newark Arts High Ensemble? Yes.
Yay.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome as WBGO celebrates Wayne Shorter. Thank you all so much for coming out. How about it, Mr. Shorter? So much. He's watching live. So we're going to need you to make some noise. Everybody know that we're having a celebration here today. In order for this to be possible, for Wayne Shorter Way to be possible, we'd like to thank the Newark City Council, and we'd like to invite City Council member LaMonica McIver.
Right. It feels like evening in here, but good afternoon. It's still a little early here. I have one of my other council colleagues that's here with me today. I'm going to ask for him to come down. He's definitely no stranger to the city of Newark and definitely not to you, because he is the baby boy of our wonderful, wonderful council president, Mildred Crump. So I'm going to ask Mr. Crump, our new Councilman Crump, to come down and join me for this resolution. So it's an honor and a pleasure for us to be here this evening. It seems like we've been working on this for a year, but really it's only been a couple of months of doing this and putting this together to have this street dedication. And I am beyond honored to be able to do this, especially with my council colleagues and with the support of them. And I'll let Councilman Crump have a couple of words as well. But we're here today to honor a pioneer here in the great city of Newark, no other than Wayne Shorter. Let's clap it up for that. You know, we have to give people their flowers while they're still here, while they can celebrate them, while they can smell them and really be here in the moment with us. So definitely he is well-deserving, more deserving for this honor, this street naming, and for us to be doing this as a city council. So I'm just here to do my business. I have like an assignment, which is to definitely present this resolution. And I'm not sure, Michelle, who's going to get it from me or who's going to take it, but we want to present this resolution to Mr. Wayne Shorter on behalf of the Newark Municipal Council, just basically making this day, commending this day as Wayne Shorter's day, as we're having this street naming today. So we have this, it's a lot of reading into this. So I'm not going to spend every moment reading this, but I will read the last couple of sentences, which says that we, the Municipal Council, celebrate Mr. Wayne Shorter, and we take honor with WBGO hosting this street renaming ceremony of Park Place to officially Wayne Shorter Way. That's big time, y'all. On this day, on April 29th, the council is definitely most honored and thankful to be able to do this for Mr. Shorter. And we are just so thankful for everything that he's contributed to this world, and specifically putting Newark on the map. Newark has some great people from Newark. We don't know. We got to let people know, educate them about the great people that come from this great city. It's not what people paint on the news all the time. We have great pioneers who have changed the world that come from this city. So congratulations to WBGO. Thank you for making this possible. And definitely congratulations to Wayne Shorter. I know he's listening in on the one. Y'all got like high tech up here. We're not used to that at the Newark Municipal Council. But it's good to see you on the screen, sir, and congratulations. I'll pass it over to Councilman Crump at this time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Councilwoman. I just want to say, you know, it's always important, as the councilman was saying, to honor someone, give their flowers while they're still here. And also, especially a son of Newark. You know, as the councilwoman was saying, we hear so many negative things, but it's time to hear more about the positive and what we're doing and what's going on. And how appropriate is it that it's right next to Sarah Vaughan Way, right? Yeah. I mean, it's just so appropriate. And the fact that WBGO, which is a pioneer in itself, station, you know, I grew up in the car with a station wagon with the panels on, listening to my parents, listening to WBGO in the parents' car and all that. So it's wonderful to be here, wonderful to present this honor. And I just thank you and appreciate being here. Thank you.
And I just want to deep, deep gratitude to both of you and the rest of the Newark City Council and the citizens of Newark, New Jersey, for taking the moment to come and honor this man who, beyond legend, beyond measure, and it's time for us to appropriately do this. And as you said, Councilman Crump, so we can deliver the bouquet while he can still smell the flowers. It's so important. It's so important. So thank you both. Thanks to the city of Newark. Deeply grateful.
You're gonna be like, again?
I don't know.
Not another song, man. But they're like, oh no, not again. Do you want to do a different order of songs this time?
Thank you.
Newark Arts High Ensemble. Give them a big round of applause. You sounded great. Let me introduce you all. First of all, good evening and welcome on this 29th day. Wait a minute, which mic am I using? It's 29th day of Jazz Appreciation Month. Thank you to the Newark Arts High Ensemble. Let's give them a big round of applause to Kennell Jones on bass. Mark Exum on the drums, Luis Arroyo. Sorry, on piano, Victor Mesquita on alto saxophone, Sara Gonzalez on trumpet, Zara Saud, vocalist, band teacher, Lawrence Liggins, and yes, music department head, Delphine Santiago, and Newark Arts High Principal, Devon Gorman. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you so very much. Thank you all so much. I am so delighted to welcome you as WBGO celebrates Wayne Shorter. My name is Leslie Harrison. I'm the host of Come Sunday on Sunday mornings, 8 a.m. to 12 noon, part of the new Rhythm and Song Weekend on Newark Public Radio Station, WBGO 88.3 FM, WBGO.org, and on your mobile devices. On behalf of all of my colleagues here, we welcome you as we gather to celebrate and to honor Wayne Shorter, saxophonist, composer, visionary, icon, and Newark native. Today, we will speak no evil as we extol the praises of the many footprints that Mr. Shorter has made in the world that began here in Newark, New Jersey in 1933. From the Ironbound section where he was born to Newark Arts High, which he attended. Yes, WBGO is very proud to have spearheaded the effort leading to today's celebration of renaming Park Place to Wayne Shorter Way. It is my utmost honor to introduce to you the visionary behind the helm of this bright moment. He works tirelessly and passionately for our listeners and for our WBGO family. He is committed to excellence and innovation, which is reflected in our programming, our community efforts, and our events, and our international achievements, as we are the best jazz radio station in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president and CEO of Newark Public Radio Station, WBGO, Stephen A. Williams.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Leslie. Very kind words. WBGO needs to say WBGO means the world to me, and I am beaming with pride at this moment right now, and even though I played a role in making this happen, you know, radio is a team sport. Okay, it doesn't really come together without teamwork. And to that end, I want to acknowledge some folk here who are also tireless in their commitment to making sure that this event would be an exemplary event. sitting right here, making sure that everything goes well. She was up at, I got an email from her at 2:57 this morning, making sure that videos were ready to go. And she's been working just every step of the way. Brandy Wood has been instrumental in making this happen. Brandy often works behind the scenes as our marketing manager. She's a veteran of the WBGO exploits. But this is like a crescendo for all of us, and wouldn't have really been able to come to fruition without you, Brandy. So thank you so much. Okay. Also, over here behind the controls, two more essential employees. Actually, I didn't recognize Anthony Nevis is also here. So Anthony Nevis, let's start from this end here. Anthony. Behind Anthony is Corey Goldberg. To Corey's left, Jamara Wakefield. And to her left, our chief technical officer, David Antoine. All of them really played a role in making sure that this would go off without a hitch. And so I'm deeply grateful to you all for your efforts. And there are a couple of other folks in here too. Jonathan Chameen, he's now by day, he is our chief financial officer, but by night, he covers all of the jazz clubs all over town, and he is one of the great photographers in all of the jazz world. And we want to make sure that we recognize Jonathan. You should see his photographs. They are really exquisite, and he deeply loves this music. So we are really lucky to have him both at the controls of our finances, which he does a fine job, but also behind the camera. So thanks, Jonathan, for your work and coming out and doing this for us today. Appreciate you. Also out here, our Director of Strategic Partnerships, Scott McCraw. Scott, holding up the wall over here with the glasses. And then there are a couple of other individuals from WBGO that are with us today. Sheila Anderson is in the back there, Sheila. She's known as the queen of hang. She's on the air at WBGO, and she's one of the veterans of WBGO. She's been for almost three decades now. I don't want to tell your age, but we are, yeah. But she has definitely been an instrumental asset to WBGO over the years. And then sitting next to her is Awilda Rivera. Awilda Rivera, longtime host at WBGO. She up and left us a few years ago. She's down in Atlanta now, but she told me she didn't want to miss this event. So she got on a plane and oh, she took the train. I thought she flew. Okay. I'm excuse me for being woefully uninformed here. But Awilda's here, so Awilda, thank you for being with us today. Over here, we have John Newcott, who is our Director of Individual Giving. Again, another instrumental member of the WBGO team. To John's right, forward, Sylvia Brewer. She's our volunteer director. She said to me earlier, since WBGO is in my blood, and I think we all feel that way, but we're so grateful to have you with us, Sylvia. Thank you so much. The food that you're eating, she's responsible for getting it in here. So we definitely need to thank her. And just behind Sylvia, our Director of Human Resources, the very first Director of Human Resources for WBGO in its 43-year history. And man, has she been one serious asset to this team. You know, there's so many things. In fact, it was Michelle that I went to for direction when I wanted to do this thing for Wayne Shorter. I went to Michelle because she has a deep understanding of Newark, the city. She's a native. She's a political expert. She knows Newark politics like nobody else. And now she's learning a new skill, which is how to be a part of a successful radio station. And this is one fine example of her contributions to early contributions to the station. So Michelle Ralph Rawls, thank you so much. And then standing to Michelle's right is our recently installed chief content officer. His name is Stephen Smith. Welcome, Stephen, as well. Am I missing anybody? Oh, Nate. Where's Nate? Oh, there he is. Okay. Our director of editorial content and also a tireless worker for WBGO, and also contributed heavily to making this a success. So Nate Chenin, and one of the finest jazz journalists in the world. We're just lucky enough to have him with us. So Nate, thank you, man, for all of that you've done for us. And then I'd like to do some acknowledgement here for someone who really, without her, we dare say the WBGO would not exist. She's a founding member of WBGO. She continues, even though in retirement, she continues to assist us in a variety of ways and leads the way. Miss Dorothon Kirk. An extraordinary human being. She really has paved the way for all of us. So we really thank you, Dorothon. Before we actually, I think Dorothon's going to actually have a few words a little bit later. But before we move on to say hello to Wayne and allow Wayne to say hello to us, there are many, many people around the world who feel as we do that Wayne Shorter is more than deserving of this recognition and then some. And we were able to reach out to a number of those individuals and ask them to contribute. And, you know, the times being what they are with COVID and so on, people can't travel in the way that they used to. But as you can see, we have a grasp on modern technology, and we use that technology to make sure that some of these people that mean so much to Wayne, and that Wayne means so much too, were able to share their feelings in brief with us today. So we have a number of video presentations that we'd like to share. Are we ready to do that now? Let's see. I think you're going to see, first you're going to see Carlos Santana, followed by Ron Carter, followed by Dee Dee Bridgewater, followed by Don Was. Don Was is the head of Blue Note Records. And then after that, you'll be seeing a few words from my good friend and a WBGO team member, Christian McBride. Whenever you're ready.
Hi, Wayne.
Hi, Wayne. Congratulations on this beautiful gift from the city of New Jersey to you, giving you your own street.
Yes, Wayne Shorter Avenue, Road, Street, Way,
Plaza.
Lane, Plaza. I want to walk on that. That's the best street in the country. Congratulations, Wayne. We love you. Sending kisses, hugs, and everything good.
Peace.
Bye. Bye, Carolina.
Bye,
we love you too.
We love you.
Bye,
like
Herbie
crazy.
And Jeezy. We love you.
Hi, this is Ron Carter. One of the reasons I'm here is to greet you for a lovely day in New York. Sun is shining, and what a great day to know that spring, while it hasn't come to New York, kind of skipped over New York, but summer's coming nearby. The other reason I'm here is to say hello to Wayne Shorter and have those of you who know who he is by his name on records know who he is by my personal commentary. Without music, without Wayne, music would still be with the hard rubber tires and the gas lights in the street. Wayne brought a new dimension to how to write for a quintet. He brought a new dimension on how to voice a piano chord and allowed me as a bass player in that band to find a variety of notes that only made the bass more important because of the melody I was trying to accompany with one of Rain's scores. I miss Wayne's affinity for old movies. One of the things on the road when we traveled, my job was to kind of monitor Wayne's purchases of books concerning old movies because somebody had to carry them. Don't look at the bass player. My job is to limit who's going to carry them, how many they are. We had great humor. We had great meals. We had great conversations. And if I could be next to Wayne now, I'd give him a real personal hug and tell him I mean it. Happy Wayne Day. Yeah. W-A-Y-N-E, not W-A-I-N. Love you, Wayne. And I'm sorry that we can't hug today, but we'll find time before the sun sets somewhere again to exchange a real huggable greeting. Thank you. Love you. And I'm missing you. Goodbye.
Hey Wayne, Dee Dee Bridgewater here, coming to you from Paris, France. I just wanted to take a moment to say congratulations to you on having Park Place in your birth city of Newark, New Jersey, renamed to Wayne Shorter Way. Honey, you have been pointing the way for us for many a year, and now we will permanently be reminded of where we need to go anytime that we are in Newark, New Jersey, coming out of WBGO or coming out of NJPAC onto Sarah Vaughan Way. Honey, 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 what can we say? I love you, Wayne. Our Newark Flash. I didn't know that about you. This is a beautiful, beautiful testimony to all that you have given us throughout your amazing career. We love you, Wayne. I love you. Dee Dee, big kisses. Mwah. Gros bisous de Paris. Ciao.
Hello, I'm Don Was, the president of Blue Note Records, the home of Wayne Shorter's recorded music from the 1960s into the 1970s and back again over the last decade. I speak for everyone at the label, both past and present, when I say that working with you has been one of the great privileges of our lives. Maestro, for me and for millions of other listeners, you've brought beauty and hope and healing and inspiration and connection to the spirits into our lives. Your music has touched us so deeply that it's really difficult to find ways to thank you properly. But naming a street after you in your hometown is a real good way to start. So congratulations on this lovely and well-deserved honor. We love you, man. See ya.
Hey everybody, it's Christian McBride. Wayne Shorter is having a street named in his honor in Newark. That's the greatest news ever. Wayne Shorter, thank you. You know you are one of my biggest heroes. You know you are one of the world's biggest heroes, but you are one of Newark's biggest heroes. All that you've given to the city is only right that there is Wayne Shorter Way. And that's the only way, baby. Love you, Wayne. Thank you, Newark. This is what should happen. Wayne Shorter Way all day.
Wow. And it doesn't stop there. We have several others who issued their congratulations and their sentiment for Wayne Shorter. We have three more videos, and this time from the political end of things. Senator Cory Booker, followed by Congressman Donald Payne Jr., and then a few words from Lieutenant Governor Sheila Oliver.
Hey everyone, it is a pleasure to share a few words today as we gather to celebrate and honor a true native son of Newark, the legendary Wayne Shorter. Look, we know this city is special because of its rich connection to music. There is a rhythm, there is a soul to this city that has helped to shape and produce so many great musical talents. And this has been a haven in particular for jazz musicians. This has been a place where greats came and greats came from. And so it is very fitting that we are now naming one of our streets in honor of one of those great musicians, someone who has represented the best of our city throughout the years. In fact, I think the best of all of America. Wayne, thank you for all that you have done and for producing music that has touched the hearts and the spirits, the very souls of so, so many. And finally, thank you, WBGO. Thank you, Mayor Ross Baraka. Thank you, members of the City Council, for making this day possible so that we can truly celebrate and honor one of Newark's finest. Look, I'm not there right now, but I look forward to coming back to Newark. And for the first time ever for me, walking on Wayne Shorter Way. God bless you all, and thank you.
Hello, I'm Lieutenant Governor Sheila Oliver. I'd like to take a moment out of today's celebrations to personally congratulate Wayne Shorter during his street naming ceremony. Wayne, as Newark's own legendary jazz artist, saxophonist, and composer. Governor Murphy and I are so excited to see that you are being recognized for your outstanding contributions to the Newark community and to the state of New Jersey. Newark is a community that is known for its deep connections to jazz and music. As a fellow Newark native and Newark Public School graduate, I know that it's inspiring for the young people here today to see your experience as a student winning an art competition at age 12 at Newark Arts High School, culminating in a lifetime of musical achievement, including winning multiple Grammy Awards. The students who are attending today's ceremony will always look up to Wayne as a role model and shining example of the type of excellence in arts that the Newark community produces for the world's stage. Thank you to WBGO for hosting this important event at the center of the arts community in Newark. I look forward to walking down Wayne Shorter Way very soon. Have a great celebration and congratulations, Wayne.
Congratulate Wayne Shorter on having Park Place renamed in his honor. He is one of the most important musicians ever to come out of Newark, and I am proud to see this street named after him. Known as the Newark Flash, Shorter has been one of the most prominent jazz musicians in American history. He has played with jazz great Miles Davis and co-founded the jazz fusion band Weather Report, one of my favorites. In his career, he has recorded 20 albums, won 11 Grammys, and even the Polar Music Prize, an honor known as the Nobel Peace Prize for Music. More than that, his compositions have been legendary in the world of jazz music. His mastery of the soprano saxophone has inspired countless jazz composers and musicians. He was considered the best saxophone player in the country for almost a decade by critics and two decades by his fans. And he has been called jazz's greatest small group composer and possibly its greatest improviser. So again, I congratulate Newark's own Wayne Shorter on this distinguished honor. He has never looked away from the city of Newark, where he grew up, and we feel important that we honor him as one of our greatest citizens. It is clearly something he deserves. Thank you.
And thank you, Congressman Payne. Mr. Shorter, the line is long for many people who want to say wonderful things and congratulate you this evening, but we want to point out two people especially. Two of former bandmates with Wayne Shorter are here this evening, Sergeant Herbert H. Fields and Lawrence Cooper. Please give them a round of applause. They're around the corner there. But oh, Newark natives and friends and bandmates of Mr. Shorter's. Okay, let's get back to the remaining videos and thank yous for Mr. Shorter. We have coming up Terry Lynn Carrington, Danilo Perez, John Patitucci, Brian Blade, Esperanza Spalding, Herbie Hancock, and Dorothon Kirk will introduce Mr. Wayne Shorter. Thank you.
Congratulations, Wayne, for this incredibly deserving recognition from WBGO. And thank you, WBGO, for acknowledging one of your own. Wayne, you have been my biggest influence, my musical, spiritual, and life mentor for over 35 years. I personally can't thank you enough for all that you've done for me, but also I can't thank you enough for all that you've done for jazz, for the younger generation, and especially for women instrumentalists who didn't always feel supported. You have always championed for what is right. You remain one of America's greatest composers and someone that has composed and played some of the most amazing music the world has ever heard. We can't thank you enough for just being who you are. I love you always and am so happy that you have this street that WBGO is housed on, named in your honor.
Doctor, congratulations. We are so proud of you. This is amazing news, and I hope this is the beginning of many, many more Wayne Shorter ways. The whole country should be called Wayne Shorter.
We love you.
Hey, Wayne, it's John. Congratulations on the street being named after you in Newark. That's just the beginning, though. I think they should start naming, you know, space stations after you. I think they should start naming maybe universes, multiverses, whatever, you know. I think they should just keep going with this idea. So love you very much. God bless you. Love from Sachi and I and all the kids. And we love you and we're proud of Wayne Shorter Way. All right.
Wayne Shorter Way. Yes. Wayne, we're so thankful for you in our lives and for you including us in your life and your vision for these last decades. One of the greatest blessings that I know for myself and for my family and for the world, everyone that might hear your music and to have the deep privilege of knowing you personally. We're just thankful, and I look forward to walking this way named after one of my greatest heroes, and to direct others as to how to get there to the Wayne Shorter Way one day. Thank you, man. We love you.
Wayne, congratulations, congratulations. And thank you to the city of Newark for recognizing this treasure, this planetary treasure, who happened to alight in the great city of Newark, New Jersey. I'm so grateful, Wayne. You so deserve this. I pray that every being who touches their foot on this street named in your honor feels the vibration, the essence, the beauty, the expansiveness of your spirit, of your essence, and all you bring to this world of music and philosophy and humor and beyond. So congratulations to Wayne Shorter Way. It's like another way of saying the Milky Way. Love you.
Hi, this is Herbie Hancock. I'm so happy to be able to congratulate my dearest friend, Wayne Shorter, and the city of his birth, Newark, New Jersey, for naming a new street called Wayne Shorter Way for the amazing, fantastic, talented, extremely talented, gifted young man that I know that will always be young, Wayne Shorter. He's got a young spirit, he's got a young heart, and he's always tackling the road that's less driven. It's fantastic. Thank you so much, Wayne, for everything you've done, and my deepest congratulations to you on this wonderful award.
Good afternoon. Bright, bright, bright moments to you. This is a day that's really historic. How special is it that the street naming to Wayne Shorter Way would be on Duke Ellington's birthday? I'm not sure how old he would have been. I'm sure there are people in the audience that know. Having said that, in the early 80s, WBGO first honored Wayne for his accomplishment. It was a full day's event, an interview at WBGO, Key to the City. He went back to his old school, Arts High School, and the concert culminated at William Patterson University, and the very young trumpet player, Wallace Roney, was a student at that time, and he performed with Wayne. I hope Mr. Shorter remembers that. In any case, today is a different story. WBGO has honored Wayne yet again, and they've taken it to a new level. The street that WBGO is currently located on, after today, in a few minutes, it will no longer be Park Place. It will be Wayne Shorter Way. All of that is very special. And as someone has said earlier in the ceremonies today, right at the corner of where we are right now is going to be Wayne Shorter Way and Sarah Vaughn Way, right in front of the Performing Arts Center, the New Jersey Performing Arts Center. So, without further ado, the special person of the day, he's a native of Newark, he's a composer, he's a saxophonist, he's known worldwide. I give you, thanks to technology, because he couldn't be with us today, I give you the great Mr. Wayne Shorter.
It's your turn.
Hello, hello.
everybody. The only thing I can think of right now is with all the surprise happenings around, you know, the only thing I can think of is when I was young, and I can't think of any grand speeches to spill out, but the only thing that stays with me is when we were very young, my brother and I and the kids in the neighborhood. See, we lived next to a vacant lot, 106 South Street, Newark, New Jersey. And this vacant lot was a place where we, in the summertime, we hung out in this lot, and it would become an ocean. It would become like landing on Mars. It would become whatever we wanted it to be, sand dunes, and it would be all kind of jungle. And we'd play in this vacant lot all day while our parents were working or shopping. So sometimes like they'd be away 8 hours. So it was the summertime, we had no school. We'd be in this vacant lot playing all day. And I remember there was no fights, arguments, and eruptions, like the challenges. We were all making up stories I know now was creating something. So when our parents came home from work or shopping, sometimes they had two jobs, they would ask us, "What have you been doing all day?" I couldn't think of anything to say, but nothing. And we were all kind of nothing. So at this time, from that time to this, I want to capture what nothing is. I don't want to lose that nothing. So that's what I'm working on now, to see what it is about nothing. And I want to thank all the people and around the world, whoever, who hoisted me up to this level of existence, and to acknowledge. I feel that you're acknowledging nothing, and nothing is the greatest mystery. And all the so-called accomplishments couldn't happen without nothing, without that kind of pure innocence that we lived with as children. So I know there's a lot of sayings about a little child shall lead thee and stuff like that, but there's a lot of truth in that, those axioms. And I want to thank everybody, all the people who spoke just now, everybody for acknowledging one of their own. We're a part of each other. So thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Mr. Shorter, thank you all so much. Thank you. This celebration continues. Thank you all for coming out. Be sure to continue to support WBGO, and we invite you all to go outside for the ribbon cutting ceremony. And remember, we have our gala coming up on June 16th, so stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for coming out. Please join us outside. We're about to open it up, and next time you address WBGO, it will be at 54 Wayne Shorter Way. Thank you all so very much.
When do they want me to do this?
Thank you. Mic check, one, two. Whenever you're ready, we have a mic for you.
Microphone while I do this other thing here. All right, ready? Okay. Okay, now the moment. really quickly before we go, we got a couple of gentlemen here who know Wayne probably better than any of us present today. They actually went to high school with Wayne and Arts High School, right? Larry. This means so much to all of us, especially Wayne. Okay? Intersection of Wayne Shorter Way and Sarah Vaughan Way. Hey, you ready? Thank you. Thank you, man. You done? Okay. Okay, now take care. Can I turn it off now? Can I get rid of it? Is it off? Is it off? We're not on the air anymore. I don't think so. There we go.